Hey guys, it's Fred from Influencer in Chain, and today I'm finally bringing you another updated Fiverr compilation with 10 new gigs pretty much anyone can do, and more than 10 free tools to help make things a lot easier. And if you're interested in freelancing on Fiverr, be sure to watch the entire video for all the gig ideas you can consider doing, since as a Fiverr seller, you can list up to 7 gigs at the same time to start with. Plus, in the description box, I also link up my other video covering 20 additional easy Fiverr gigs and over 20 free tools. So be sure to watch that video after this one. Also, I'm going to be giving away $15 in PayPal money to one lucky winner, but the instructions are going to be a bit different from before. So this time, in order to enter the competition, you actually need to go and follow me over on Twitter at influencer_UNCH, which I'll also link below in the description, and it'll be linked on my channel page as well. And besides that, you'll also have to comment below this video which Fiverr gig you're the most excited to try, plus leave your Twitter account username within that comment so that if you win, I can actually message you. And before we get started with the video, be sure to utterly destroy the like button as it really helps me out, and also subscribe to my YouTube channel for more cutting edge videos about making money online and digital entrepreneurship just like this one. And with that, let's get right into the video. So getting right to the first Fiverr gig I want to show you today, plus several free tools you can use to do it, we have Domain Research, which is coming up with website URLs for people, and it's listed under the digital marketing category on Fiverr. And if you just take a look at some of these gigs right here, all you really need to do is provide some domain name ideas that are also available, because sometimes domain names, when they overlap, you can't create the exact same one, right? So what a person does here, or a seller does here, is they find ones that are still available and also works for a given business. And if you look more closely at some of the gigs here, like this one with the guy on the far left, as well as this one on the far right, we can see that first of all, this person here is charging $25 for 5 to 6 SEO friendly domain suggestions, meaning the URL should not only be available, but they should also contain relatively memorable words, which are actually quite easy to come up with, as I'll show you very soon. And similarly, this guy right here is also charging $25 for a bundle of 5 domain names that fit a project or business or whatever they need. And all you really need to do for these types of gigs is, again, have your clients tell you what type of project or business idea or whatever type of domain they need in whatever niche. And then you can just use the tools I'm about to show you to generate ideas for them. And the first of these is actually going to be a domain name checker right over on my website, which I assure you is accurate because I actually have access to this tool by being an affiliate of Bluehost, which is also the web hosting service I use, which comes loaded with WordPress for building websites. And this tool is actually hosted on my tutorial for building websites, and I'll link up the page below for your convenience. But anyway, the way you would use this is by simply typing in any domain name you want. By the way, you need to scroll down to the tool here. Whoops, the tool right here. And then after you type in any domain name, you'll be able to check whether or not it's currently available. By the way, if you're using Google Chrome and have Adblock installed, you'll have to actually turn it off for this tool to be able to work. So anyway, for example, if I just search up a domain name such as my own, influencerandchain.com, and click on check availability, this should indicate that it's not available, right? As you can see, it says influencerandchain.com is taken. Please try again, because that is my domain name. And as for how you can actually get good ideas for domain names, if you want, you can first go over to Google Trends to find out what might actually be trending the most lately. For example, The Last of Us, which is a video game, has just released, and as you can see on the graph, it's really popular lately. And perhaps another more helpful free tool to generate some, to actually generate some names is Shopify's very own business name generator. And to use it, you can simply scroll down here to this blank space and enter whatever niche, product idea, brand name, whatever, to generate some names related to it. So for example, I can type in something like taco. If say your client wants to open up a website for taco store or taco truck, I can just hit generate names here. And once some of these ideas have been generated, and as you can see, there are actually a lot here, and I think they're actually quite decent, but it's no guarantee that all these have not already been taken as a domain name, right? So what you want to do is, for example, there's Miracle Taco. You can just copy up this name and then go over to my website here and just punch it into the domain name checker to see whether it's available, right? So I can do Miracle Taco and hit check availability. And let's see, this one is actually available, so this could actually work as one of the ideas to give to your client. And that was the first Fiverr gig I wanted to show you, which was domain name suggestions. And so moving forward to the second gig out of 10, we have mockups, which is essentially product images such as of t-shirts and boxes that have a specific design or logo displayed on them, generally provided by your client. For example, this seller here creates images and videos of models wearing any t-shirt design provided to them. And they charge, let's see, $10 for 10 pictures and 5 videos, which may sound like quite a bit of work, but is actually not, using a website made for this called Placeit. All you need to do is to go over to the mockups tab on the top left here, and then you can actually first select free mockups to see what is available, so let me just do that really quick. And then once it loads up, you can actually go over to the left menu here. As you can see, there's a list of different categories. And first of all, you want to make sure to on the drop-down selection here to select free mockups. Okay, and then down here, you can then select the type of mockup you want. So for example, we have some for books, some for coffee mugs, sweatshirts, dog collars. I don't know if you'll need that. Hoodies, hats, and so on and so forth. So let's try the t-shirt mockup right here. So let me just click on it. All right, as you can see right here, we have a bunch of free t-shirt mockup templates that you can literally just upload a design onto and even change the color of the t-shirt to then download the image and give to your client, right? And if I just scroll through here, as you can see, there are a lot of different templates. And for example, I'm just gonna open up this one here to demonstrate it really quick. So right here, I need to wait for it to load. All right, and as you can see, this is actually quite customizable, because over on the left here, you can even add text. You can upload your own designs or logos. And on the right, you can also even add from their graphic pool and change the shirt color as well. So for instance, I can change my shirt color to like navy or dark blue. Let's make it darker actually. And then I'm gonna select one of my images that I've already created for some of my own t-shirt merch. By the way, merch store link down below. And here, once I have it uploaded, I can actually adjust it as well, make it larger or smaller, move it around, and then hit crop. And as you can see here, it'll show up right on the shirt once it finishes loading. And wait for it. Wait for it. There it is. Voila. And once you're satisfied with your mockup, you can then scroll up to the top to download it for free by clicking on the link right here, provided you're actually using one of their free templates. So as you can see, I need to hit download again. And if you haven't logged in already, you gotta log in as well. And by the way, you can create an account completely for free. And besides just having images as templates like these, Placeit also provides lots of free video templates as well. And by the way, several of these mockups I've actually used for my own merch store, and I can actually show you over on my Instagram page. By the way, follow me on Instagram because I actually share stuff that I don't do on YouTube. But anyway, here on the right here, there's a carousel post as you can see. And this mockup was actually made completely on Placeit for free, save for the t-shirt design itself, which I got made for me on Fiverr. But if I just scroll through this, there's even a video here, so I can actually play this mockup video for you to see. Check this out, this is pretty cool, right? It looks super natural and professional. This is also made on Placeit, obviously. And if I just scroll through, here are a couple more of my different designs using different templates. And although I've only used free templates here, if you actually need more templates for your Fiverr gig, let's say if you want to offer a higher tier package with say 20 to 30 mockups and charge more, you can also consider mixing in some of the paid mockups or actually just subscribe to Place It for a low monthly fee to expand your repertoire that much more, and also just use a small portion of what you'd earn from Fiverr anyway to cover the costs. And that was mockup design or gig number two. And so moving on to gig number three, it's technically not one gig, but rather a collection of design gigs, many of which share or use similar tools. So I've actually decided to group them together and also point out some of the newer options that have come out on Fiverr. And the first of these, as you can see under graphics and design, and then packaging and labels, and it's also labeled as new, we have album cover design. And this can actually be done over on Placeit as well. For example, if I hit to the designs link here and then click on free designs, then filter by album cover maker, here we have a bunch of free templates you can also edit and use as any of your album designs. So for example, if I just open up this one here called Kenya East, kind of a funny name. Again, here you can customize the text and change their font and colors. And then on the right, you can also select different icons you may want to add to your album cover, as well as change the background color. And then you can also choose from one of their royalty-free images to use as the background image, or you can just get a picture or photograph from your client to upload onto this template. And notice how there is currently a watermark on this image, but rest assured, when you actually download it, the watermark will indeed be removed. And that was album cover design, which is kind of a new thing on Fiverr, and it looks like people have been charging pretty good amounts for them as well. But moving on to the next type of design gig, still on number three though, because again, I've decided to group them together, we actually have all sorts of so-called print designs, as they're called on Fiverr, with gigs ranging from flyer design to brochure design to menu design and even yard signs. And for making these, my top recommendation is going to be Canva.com, and I've actually been using Canva Pro myself for various things, and you can actually try it for free for not one but 2 months. And I also leave my affiliate link below for just the free version of Canva for you to sign up, which will actually also come with a special bonus where each time you create a design, we'll both get awarded one Canva credit we can use toward pay designs, which is indeed a win-win situation. Anyway, how you would normally do these designs is your client will usually provide you with, say, a list of menu items or a guest list or whatever they need. Then all you need to do is add in those lists into the respective templates, reformat them a little bit to fill out the page, and possibly change up some of the images as well, which is very easy to do with Canva Pro because it's got tons of images ready for you to use, and with Pro you'll get access to all the different templates as well, not just the free ones. And even if you want to stay a free user on Canva, that's perfectly fine. And if you want to also get even more options to design with, Krillo.com is a competitor to Canva, and then Adobe Spark is another website, and again, Placeit. They all come with additional free templates and assets you can use alongside those on Canva. And for yet another design gig that I want to point out, one that's always going to be high in demand is t-shirt design, which along with the aforementioned platforms, you can also utilize a website called Creative Fabrica, recommended by Teespring themselves, to grab some of their free merch and t-shirt designs and daily gifts that rotate in and out, and they also come with commercial licenses. Moving forward onto gig number four, we have another one that's been newly added onto Fiverr, and it is article to video, which is converting blog articles into slideshow videos that have clips that match the text, as well as a voiceover if needed. And there are a couple of ways I want to show you that you can use to create these types of videos. First, you can simply use a browser-based software called VidNami to literally copy and paste in articles or paragraphs your clients provide, then have it literally auto-generate a slideshow video for you with a voiceover and with commercial rights. Now, VidNami is not free, but it's definitely tremendously helpful if you want to create these types of videos, not only for Fiverr freelancing, but you can also use it to make videos for your own YouTube channel, which you can then make money from. And for a demonstration and tutorial of VidNami, and to see how easy to use and powerful it is, I'll link up my other video for that in the description box below. And I'll also include my referral link because I'm partnered with them, that'll get you an exclusive 25% off deal for life. And in addition to that, if you use my link, you'll also receive these free bonus guides that'll help you create better videos and monetize them in multiple ways, such as through more freelancing opportunities and on YouTube. But if for whatever reason you don't want to use VidNami, You can also make slideshow videos using a basic video editor, such as one that might have been preloaded with your computer, like iMovie for Macs and Windows Movie Maker. Then download the relevant royalty-free video clips from pexels.com, add in the text if needed using your editor, then either provide your own voiceovers or pay somebody to do it for you, or just have your friend do it for you. Or you can also use a free voiceover generator such as fromspeechtotext.com, although the voice that comes out likely isn't going to sound as natural. And with that, leading into our fifth gig, we have a category that is somewhat related, which is explainer videos, including slideshow videos, which you can also use Vietnami for, and there are also animated explainer videos such as whiteboard videos, which you can generally charge a lot more for. And to create these whiteboard animation videos, there are a few softwares you can consider online, but one of the most popular ones, which I personally used before as well for YouTube, is called VideoScribe. And I'll also include a link to my tutorial for it in the description box below. And if you're interested, you can first sign up for VideoScribe's free trial to test it out and learn. Then if somebody purchases your gig, you can then use what you earn to cover for the cost of VideoScribe. And those are gigs 4 through 5, which entail creating various types of videos. And moving on to gig number 6, we have survey and form creation, and actually performing surveys. First, you can actually just design a form very easily and for free using Google Forms, which also comes with built-in templates such as this one here, on which you can just add any type of question or field you want using this toolbar on the right. And if you want, you can actually command even higher prices by not only creating forms for your clients, but also administering their surveys as well. And for this, if you don't normally have people you can send your surveys to, you can also take to micro-tasking sites like MicroWorker as well as RapidWorker to get people to fill them out and just pay them a few cents each. On to gig number 7, we actually have a new category on Fiverr, which is social media advertising under digital marketing. And what you actually do for this is basically help people set up various ads such as Facebook ads, Instagram ads, Google ads, etc. And the great thing about this is that most of the ad platforms actually provide free training and sometimes even actual certification for running ads. For example, we've got for Facebook here, we've got the Facebook for Business Learning Center. And then for Google, we have a Google Skill Shop with Google Ads and where you can also get certified, as well as for Microsoft, we have the Microsoft Advertising Learning Lab, where you can also get certified as a Microsoft Advertising professional. Plus, I also have a tutorial for setting up a Facebook pixel, which is crucial for tracking people who visit a website, for one to be able to retarget them with ads. And I'll link this video in the description box as well. Going on to gig number 8, we have email marketing, which can actually entail a lot of different things, from helping people get set up on a given email platform such as MailChimp, or providing them with email marketing templates to doing copywriting. But like with social media ads, I also think that email marketing is fairly easy to learn, especially with all the tutorials and templates provided right to you from most of these email marketing platforms that you yourself can sign up for. And for example, on GetResponse, which is what I use, you'll not only get optimized email templates for various purposes that you can use for your clients, but it also comes with pre-built email marketing funnel templates that you can actually save and download as templates for your clients to re-upload. And like with many of the other methods I've shared, I also have a step-by-step tutorial on GetResponse that I'll link in my description, along with a sign-up link you can use if you're interested. And that was email marketing at number 8. And going on to number 9 is research and summaries, for which you can actually help people conduct research on any given topic and provide some citations for them. And a website that is deceptively good for this is actually Google itself, but not just a normal Google search, but rather Google's advanced search for finding actually credible sources and or academic research. And the trick to doing this is down over by the domain box right here, you type in .edu for educational websites, or .gov for government websites like I've done here, or .org for organizations, all of which will generally give you legitimate sources which you are safely or you can safely cite for a given topic. And for example, here I've typed in social distancing and have .gov, and I can just hit advanced search. And as you can see here, besides the ad at the top, all the websites that have come up are government websites, including the CDC, which is the Center for Disease Control, which is definitely a legitimate source. And this is another one from the CDC and so on and so forth. So you can generally safely quote and get accurate research from these types of websites. And finally, going on to the last gig, at number 10, we have ebook creation, which can be very easily done and can be very profitable indeed if you just use a software called Scribble to generate and format ebooks pretty much in a few clicks, with even the contents created automatically for you from their huge article database. Therefore, I definitely recommend Scribble, especially if you also want to use ebooks to make money elsewhere, such as selling them or using them as lead magnets to build your email list. Alternatively, if you're a good writer, you can also design ebooks using Canva.com and perhaps combine that with Google Docs, which are both free. But I would still recommend to at least take a look at Scribble, which I also link in the description box for your convenience. And that was 10 Fiverr gigs plus over 10 tools you can learn and master fairly easily. But because they would still generally be considered as active income, I personally prefer more passive income methods, such as those taught by my top recommended step-by-step courses, which will be the first link in the description box. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Like the video if you liked it or found it helpful. Remember to subscribe to my channel and ring the notification bell for more videos about making money online and digital entrepreneurship just like this one. And with that, I'll see you in the next video. Peace.